rights, our health, our education, our transport system, and the battle against climate change has lost out. Because although we can't claim to own all the 13 billion, a considerable chunk of it probably would have come to us. So all that happened today was that the EU court ruled that Irish tax law has created a tax haven in this country, that they weren't guilty of breaking any Irish tax laws, but we have constructed our laws to allow an immoral 0.005% of tax on a global corporation that makes absolutely billions on a daily basis. There's no moral justification for it. It's outrageous that we do that, but it has actually affirmed that Ireland is a tax haven. But that's what that ruling has done.
I have to put it to you. I think it's over 200,000 direct jobs and another 100,000 indirect jobs from all these IDA industries. And you know, when you see the monthly exchequer returns, the one thing that's keeping the country going is maybe 16 billion in corporation tax. If it ain't broke, why fix it?
Well, it is true. Apple employs about 6,000 people in this country. But 6,000 people make their profits. It's not like Apple come here and just give us jobs and thanks very much, we're all delighted. They actually make vast profits for that company. And globally, those profits are siphoned off so that they don't pay taxes. I mean, there was incidents back in the 90s when there were 3 or 5 years that Apple paid no taxes whatsoever in any country. That is unbelievable. Nobody else would get away with that except these multinational companies who are pampered by our tax haven system.
Do you not accept that the EU Commission have an agenda here? They want the same tax from the poorest and most peripheral regions as the rich countries of Germany and so on. And that we need these incentives to make people come here.
No, we don't. We don't need incentives of 0.005%. If they were to pay 12.5%, that would still be the lowest corporation tax in Europe. But even if they paid half of that, 6%, it would go a huge way towards funding our health service, our much-needed childcare service, the transport system, which is in bits. There's so many things you could think about. Workers have to pay the full share of tax. But these profit makers, and there's only a handful of individuals who actually gain very, very vast wealth from it. They get away with murder, literally with murder. And we have constructed it. The Irish state, the revenue commissioners and consecutive governments have constructed. Well, I'm sorry, these are not victimless scams. There are victims to these kind of scams. There are the queues in the hospitals. There's the trolley crisis. There's the kids that can't have the operations.
There's all the backlog of public services. You have constituents who are paying.
To the taxation issue. And I, you know, since the Apple case and the facts of the Apple case were presented, a lot of loopholes have been closed up. The double Irish is now gone. We have a number of, made a number of progressive steps to strengthen the transparency issue that was lacking. And, you know, international tax is an evolving thing. It's not a stationary thing. And we do have to have the conversation, have that debate as to where our tax system is going. And I accept some of the points that Bríd is making in relation to that. But to portray this to the Irish people like this is some kind of windfall that we've turned our back on is completely incorrect.
Hang on a second, Lorraine. We spent 8 million in appealing the case. Had we taken the 13 billion at the time and other countries said to us, no, some of that belongs to us, some of that belongs to us. An awful lot of production happened in this country of the goods that were sold, the intellectual property rights, etc. Had we taken it, we could have thrown our arms open and say, right, let's come and listen to what you have to say. What countries think they are owed some, let's try and work it out. But a considerable chunk of it would have belonged to us.
If we didn't appeal that, we would be admitting that the Irish state and the revenue cannot or have inappropriately applied the laws that we made it.
No, exactly. But, the Irish state and the revenue have inappropriately applied tax laws.
The laws were appropriate.
The general court decided that we acted properly.
We acted properly according to our own laws, but the Irish state and Lorraine's party and the parties that are currently in government, bar the Green Party, have constructed it in such a way that they have allowed this utterly immoral tax scam where 0.005%.
It's our own decision that we
look at the history of Apple. They approached the revenue commissioners back in the 90s and they said, let's
do issues that shouldn't be
corruption. I mean, it is an incentive that you might not like. You may think it's unjust.
I think it's
not
corruption.
A scam.
I believe it's corrupt for a multinational.
Well, it's lawful.
It's lawful, but it doesn't mean it's not corrupt.
But you say this is a It's an ideological difference. And, you know...
So what do you think we should do?
Allow them
to get away with this consistently?
How low can you go?
0.005%. I'm angry about it, as are people out there.
And actually, you know, you're referring to something that is not in place today. You're referring to what happened with Apple in the past. We've changed the Double Irish no longer exists.
There are a number of points that have strengthened the position.
Is it not the case that in reality, if we had never appealed it, Apple would have appealed it anyway? And is it not the case that this was around intellectual property, a lot of which was designed in California and wasn't designed here? And that in fact, as will now probably happen, the US government will get the money. It's not that Apple won't pay the tax.
Well, the US government may get the money, but had we taken it, like I said earlier on, and not appealed it, you're probably right, Apple may have appealed it, but let them pay the entire cost of it, which is probably $16 million.
But Bríd hasn't answered
because we paid $8 million.
What I asked Bríd, then that would be an admittance that the Irish state and revenue have acted inappropriately in relation to the laws that we have made in this country. We are entitled to make our own.
By creating those laws in the first place.
We are entitled, and the Irish state, with a legitimately elected government, is entitled to create tax laws. And then, you know, if we hadn't appealed it, it would be an admittance that we have somehow inappropriately applied those.
What would be an admittance?
So it's disingenuous.
You keep telling me to listen to you. I'm saying to you, I'm answering the question you asked. What would be inappropriate is that Fianna Fáil, consecutive governments led by Fianna Fáil and Fine Gael, have constructed tax laws in this country that are totally immoral. And they've constructed them on the basis of allowing multinational corporations benefit hugely from the production of Irish workers in this country. And that has not changed.
That we do need to have a conversation, and I think you do make some valid points.
We should admit that it's immoral.
No, we need to have a conversation in relation to the digital tax and have it as a conversation that we have at OECD level and have an agreement there.
Look, I think what we're facing here is, you know, to ordinary people out there, it looks like an absolute scam. You may not like me calling it that on TV. Apple are walking away, and people here, as public services, have suffered very, very badly.
Thank you both for joining us tonight.